Hey everybody, welcome back to the Valley of the Last Dinosaurs. Today, I'm excited to be coming to you from the field with Erica Evans, and she's kind of the brains behind this big mapping project we've been trying to pull off all summer long. So Erica, every day I get out here, I see you running around on top of hills and down in the bottom of valleys, carrying around this thing, and I've heard you call it a science stick. What are you doing out here?
Yeah, so what we're trying to do is create a plane of the KT boundary. So we're trying to approximate roughly at what elevation the dinosaurs have gone extinct and project that out over the surface. So I use this equipment to take really high precision GPS points. We have a handheld GPS that's attached to the staff, and we have an antenna on top that allows us to read signals from satellites in space, which is pretty
cool.
Okay,
so that's what you're doing out here. You're basically walking around and mapping in that plane that represents the extinction of the dinosaurs.
Yeah, that's correct.
Oh, that's cool. And you use all this high-tech equipment. So what's this big thing behind us that I keep seeing you set up on the hills?
Well, this is something that you call the brain. This is the base station. So this sits out here all day, and it is just receiving signals from various satellites. And it is able to calculate the offset in those signals, and we can use them to correct back what we get on this handheld.
Oh, wow. So that's how this whole setup is way more precise than anything you would get at like REI or whatever, just to do normal navigating out here.
That's correct. The majority of our data points are below 5 centimeters in accuracy, so they're really close to what they actually are.
Okay, this is going to sound dumb, but why do we need to be that precise when you're doing this kind of mapping project?
Well, a big part of this mapping project is we're trying to see where dinosaur sites are located, and plant sites as well, are located relative to the KT boundary. So this precision allows us to create a three-dimensional model of where that boundary is, and we can project that out into areas where the boundary may not be present.
Okay, so if you find a fossil way out there where there's no contact at all, at least you can measure up to that plane you projected and figure out where it is in time relative to the rest of the stuff.
That's correct, yes.
Oh, that's so cool. Well, so we've got Erica Evans, her science stick, and her GPS brain wandering around out here. How many miles do you cover carrying all this around?
A long day is probably like 10 or more.
Miles?
Miles.
Oh my God, up and down this kind of terrain?
Yeah, we do a lot of hiking.
Yeah, every time I see you, you're up on some ridge somewhere, kind of like peering off into the distance. So what a big project. How many sites have you got mapped in so far?
So far, we have about 140 vertebrate localities and then over 300 points of contact for the KT boundary.
Oh my God, what an ambitious project, but it's going to be so cool when you guys get done. I can't wait to see the model.
It's going to be pretty cool.
I understand this is going to be probably the most ambitious and complete model of the boundary that's ever been created in this area.
Yes, this should be one of the most comprehensive terrestrial data sets for the KT extinction event.
Oh my gosh. So. Well, thanks for being with us. Better let you go right now because I know you've got miles to go before you sleep, but thanks for talking to us.
Yeah, of course.
All right.
See you later.
See you guys.